What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about upgrading your SCCM to 2111. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first things first, let's open up your SCCM console. Click on the file tab, which I consider the file tab, right? And we're going to click on About Configuration Manager. You're going to get this nice little dialog box. And I'm just showing you guys that I'm running version 2107. This is one of the core requirements to get to 2111. During this video or during this time that I took these snapshots, I actually had to download the Enable Early Update Ring to get 2111 within my testing environment. But I believe 2111 is now production. All right, so you could basically just skip all this. But I basically downloaded the exe file, I right-clicked on it, I ran it as an administrator, and it's going to want me to extract the files. I clicked OK. You get a nice little warning that the extraction was completed, and click OK. Now, this process, all it does is drop a PowerShell script that is going to basically talk to your SCCM server and enable the 2111 early within your environment so you could test it out. Now from here, I am going to click on start and basically type in Windows PowerShell, and I am going to right click on Windows PowerShell ISE, and I'm going to run it as an administrator. It's going to load up. What you're going to do is you're going to go to File, Open, and open that PowerShell script that we extracted from that exe file. And it's going to want you to enter your site server. Now, your site server is your SCCM server, and make sure you enter the full qualified domain name. Mine is bj-sccm.btnhd.edu. Click Enter. If everything works well, you should get the command completed successfully. Now, remember, 2111, from my understanding, is already in the production, so you don't really need to do this. Now, one of the core requirements for 2111 is you got to make sure you are running the latest and greatest .NET framework, right? If you don't have it, 2111 is going to produce an error behind the scenes, and it won't install correctly for you. So make sure you are running the latest framework within your SCCM server. Now, for me, I downloaded the latest one. I basically, you know, right clicked on it, running as an administrator, and I was running the latest one during the time that I take these snapshots. But for you, make sure you are running the latest one on your SCCM server. We're going to open up our console, and from here we are going to go inside administration, overview, updates and servicing, and you're going to see your 2111 build. And underneath the state column, it is going to indicate ready to install. Now, we're going to select it and right-click on it and then click on Install Update Path. I know a lot of you will basically do the second option to check if you have all the requirements for it to install successfully. But if you do the first option, it's automatically going to check for you. So just go for it. So we're going to Install Update Path. If you want, you're able to ignore the check. In a testing environment, you basically get away with that, but in a production environment, I say don't do that. Once you pick your answer, click on next. And these are some of the features that are included for that particular update. You are able to choose it now. If not, you are able to choose it later. Once you pick your options, just click on next. And client update settings, you have two options. I typically leave the default one in. It is update without validating, and then click next. Accept the license and terms, and then click on next here. Because I don't have my SCCM attached to a cloud service, just make sure you uncheck all this and just click on next. If you do, make sure you sign in and just follow the prompts. You're going to get a nice little summary. Click next here. It's going to start doing its thing. And if you get green check marks, you are able to continue. So we are going to close that. Now, underneath the state column, it's going to state installing. Eventually, it's going to start checking for the core requirements to see if your machine is able to install this upgrade, you know, successfully. Once it's completed, walk away, come back, you know, go to lunch or whatever. For me, it took almost a day. It always takes about a day for it to process. But when you go back inside your SCCM server, you're going to see this nice little tab that says a new version of console is available. And then you have to click on the hyperlink that says install the new console version. When you click on that, your console is going to automatically close up. You're going to get this dialog box that it is downloading the files. So just let it be. Eventually, you're going to get the Microsoft Endpoint Configuration Manager Console, which is the correct name. I know a lot of you guys are probably yelling at me like, it's not SCCM anywhere. I'm old school. That's what we used to call it, SCCM, right? System Configuration, wait, what is it? System Center Configuration Manager. Microsoft decides to change it to MECM. Whatever, right? It's the same thing. Once this is processed, it's going to go to the next phase. Once it starts prepping for the removal and the installation, it's going to start updating any extensions. And if everything works well, your console should load up automatically for you. Give it some time. Sometimes it takes some time behind the scenes because it's still doing some stuff. On the upper left side, you can click on the File tab, and we're going to click on About Configuration Manager. And you're going to see that you're running the latest version, which is 2111. Awesome. And if you go back inside administration, overview, updates and servicing, it's going to clean it up and you're going to see your last upgrade, which is here. Now, once your SCCM is fully upgraded, the next steps are to upgrade your client as well as update your boot images. And then from there, I would say deploy a Windows operating system within a virtual environment or a physical machine to make sure everything is working with the new upgrade, right? Hopefully you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.